You've heard a lot about Azure Arc and Azure Arc-enabled data services. In this video, we'll dive deep into what that means and what opportunities it opens for you. Tune in to this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Tolga, a program manager on the Azure Data team. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks so much, Anna, for hosting me today. I greatly appreciate it, and greatly appreciate the opportunity to talk to you about our Azure Arc Data Services and provide you an overview with that service.
Yeah, I mean, I'm really excited to learn more. You know, there's been a lot of hype around Azure Arc, so I'd love to just pass it back to you and let you kind of explain to us what is Azure Arc.
Yeah, fantastic. Thanks so much. Greatly appreciate it. So as you know, the hybrid environment for our customers are basically becoming more challenging. As you know, more customers are having diverse infrastructure with their own data centers, or they're using other cloud service providers such as Google or AWS. So a lot more infrastructure complexities are becoming introduced to the marketplace. And a lot of customers are trying to modernize their data centers by using Azure Stack services. Azure Hybrid Data Services basically will provide you the single control plane by using the Azure capability. So what does that technically mean? So more and more customers have different diverse infrastructure, meaning, you have your own data centers that are various in locations. You might be having a footprint on AWS or Google Cloud. So becoming more and more complicated. So what our goal basically is to bring all those infrastructure and then have the ability to basically control that from a single control plane via basically Azure and using the Arc technology. So customers can technically also modernize their data stacks and also extend their edge capabilities by using IoT services. So this is the fundamental benefit of bringing Azure Hybrid Data Services to your infrastructure. So what do we basically mean by data services anywhere, at a glance, basically? So the key benefit is here that you can basically be on any kind of Kubernetes services that you may be on, or any kind of OEM hardware or Azure Stack, GPC, or Amazon. So we basically are giving you the opportunity to basically be on multiple different types of Kubernetes or any kind of hardware. And if you look at it from a stacks perspective, at the very top, you have your application, your BIs, solutions, and so forth, which are powered then by database services. And then our Arc management application, our controller basically, that enables all the provisioning, the backup, the restore, the scaling, and all the activities that you can do today are done by this management solution, basically. So this also gives you the ability to basically link your database services back to Azure as well, where you can do Azure monitoring, Azure security, backup, ATP, and role-based access can be basically brought down from there, from Azure technically down to your on-premise databases. So, and what is it, the difference between on-premise versus Azure? As you can see on the left side, we have Azure infrastructure, and these are PaaS offerings that Microsoft has, and this can be SQL Server, Postgres, Cosmos, and so forth. And on the other side, we have the customer's infrastructure. This is managed by the customer itself. And this basically is totally disconnected, from the Azure. It's, all customer's hardware. And then, if you look at it from an architectural standpoint, how does basically Azure Arc Data Services work? At the very bottom, we have our persistent storage. And then on top of that, we have nodes that are working with different types of Kubernetes services. And, like I said earlier, this Azure Arc controller basically enables you to do all these various different activities, monitoring logs, being sent back to Azure portal, backup, restore, provisioning, patching within the environment is basically done with this controller after you have basically installed it. You can technically install a Postgres hyperscale, or you can also install, a SQL managed instance into your infrastructure. And the way it works is basically very simple. Once you have the Kubernetes installed on it, you can interact via Kubernetes commandlets, or you can, you know, interact via Azure Data Studio. It's a GUI-based application that you can download and then, you know, do your provisioning and so forth. Or you can go to the Azure portal and still interact with your infrastructure from there, you know, if you're on a connected mode. So if you're connected, you can technically send all this information back to Azure, your resources, your logs and telemetry, backup, retention, consumption, all that information can be loaded back to Azure. At the flip side, from Azure, you can basically get RBAC policy, you know, advanced data protection, deployments, and so forth can be all taken down from Azure back to your infrastructure locally. And, you know, you have several basically management capabilities. Like I mentioned earlier, you have the Azure portal, you have the Azure Data Studio, or the Kubernetes APIs that you can use to interact with this solution or any third-party solution that might come around later down the road, obviously. So this is on a high level of overview on how Azure Arc data controller and how the overall system ecosystem basically works. And, you know, what are basically some of the key differences between like today's SQL Server and Azure? You know, here's a list of all these additional capabilities that we're bringing to the customer so that they can technically manage their infrastructure with additional capabilities. You know, the key differences that you can see between SQL Server today and the, you know, Arc is basically, you know, you have the automatic upgrade and patching, you know, backup, restore, monitoring. These are all built-in additional services into the service offering. You know, the service is also now an evergreen, meaning, you know, you're always on the latest and greatest SQL engine versus, you know, if you're using a box product, you might be on SQL Server 2017 or earlier version even. So when you basically switch over to managed instance, the version management actually goes away even as well. You do also get elasticity because of the Kubernetes services. You know, Kubernetes will basically enable the services to be scaled up and scaled down easily. In today's SQL Server, you don't have these kind of capabilities. And because of the Kubernetes, that's the underlying one of the underlying infrastructure components, you also get the automatic HADR capabilities. But obviously, these are all managed on, or these are all managed by the customer's infrastructure. So it's essentially the customer's responsibility to make sure that these infrastructures are up and running compared to Azure. You know, this is all managed by us.
Thanks, Tolga. You know, I think that was a really great explanation. I certainly learned quite a few things about the infrastructure and kind of like what the team is doing. I see it really interesting because you can kind of get the best of both situations in some aspects. You know, you get to keep it on-prem or wherever it is that you have, even if it's cross-cloud, if I'm understanding that correctly. Yep. And then, but you also get some of the PaaS benefits, like, you know, this evergreen type of service and even some HADR type of capabilities. Can I ask you, you know, what type of customer scenarios are we seeing people do with Azure Arc?
Yeah, so, you know, we have various different types of customers that have actually participated in our private preview program so far. And, you know, you will basically see, you know, customers that are in manufacturing, they may have like remote locations that they want to make sure that they have their infrastructure up and running all the time. That is more resilient infrastructure at that location, at that site location. You might have customers that are on multi-cloud infrastructure that want to basically manage all their database assets in one location. You know, if you are using too many different cloud providers, it becomes a little bit more harder and challenging to manage all your infrastructure in one provider versus another one versus another one. We also have customers that are using it in retail operations as well. You know, they have like different types of retail location. And, you know, with the service, you can technically now install a database service and remotely manage it a lot simpler than in the past. So these are some of the different types of scenarios that we see customers adopting, basically.
Cool. So, awesome. I'd love to see, you know, some of this in action. Like, is there anything you can show us?
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the things that I wanted to show to you all as well is basically on how we're basically managing different types of infrastructure at different locations, right? So this is basically AKS HCI. This just got announced as well today for public preview. And what we did is this is an on-prem instance, and we basically have a database instance on this Kubernetes services. And we technically then took that instance and displayed it to our Azure subscription by using Arc for Kubernetes services. And this database right here, SQL MI 01, is actually sitting inside this AKS on Azure Stack HCI, which this is a technically an on-prem infrastructure. At the same time, you know, I also took another instance and I called it Contosa EKS, which is on our, which is on an Amazon subscription. And we linked that as well with Arc for Kubernetes services onto our subscription. And there is also a managed instance inside this Contosa EKS. As you can see, it's right here, Arc Contosa EKS. And this is the managed instance that is sitting within this EKS cluster. So as you can see, there's a lot of different alternative ways to see your instances and how they're technically operating within the ecosystem.
Very cool. Awesome, Tolga. I mean, this is really cool to actually see something on-prem versus in the Azure portal or running in Azure versus running in AWS. I got to say, this is the first time we've ever showed anything from AWS on this show. So it's really interesting to see that you can get the same technology, like you were saying, kind of like anywhere you are. You know, as we kind of think to close out the video, like what would you recommend our viewers do to either get started or learn more? Or like how's the best way forward?
Right. So our users can technically visit our, you know, Azure portal. And, you know, if they have already, if they don't have a subscription, they can go and obviously read about the services and the offering on the Azure portal. Or if they actually have the a subscription, they can technically go and search for in the marketplace or, you know, up top here, Azure Arc, and they will be technically offered the service going forward. So this is one way of, you know, doing the Arc for data services.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much for sharing all this great information with our, with myself and with our viewers. We'll put some links in the description for you to go learn more. If you watch the show and you enjoyed the show, please like this video and leave us a comment to let us know what you think you might be using Azure Arc for in the future. With that, we'll see you next time on Data Exposed.